reverse unboxing starts with an idea and motivation to create flat sounding studio headphones. It's then followed by audio engineers, multiple audio engineers, banging their heads against the wall in the prototyping and sourcing stage. And then the reverse unboxing ends with the quality control and boxing so that you can joyfully unbox them. Coming up. The X1 are like a baby, like a perfect baby, taking only the best parts from both parents. In our case, the S4X that were released in 2019 and the S5X that were released in 2021. So how did this idea to have a baby out of these two came about? Well, we listen. We really listen. We closely listen and actively search for ideas and opinions and feedback, the good and the bad, from you guys, from the community, from OLLO community and, you know, community in general. So the idea for the X1 was collectively co-created with you guys. We just brought it to life. So what elements did the community, you guys, identify as the core building blocks for a perfect studio headphone? Well, I can put that in four categories. So one would be sound, obviously, flat sound, neutral sound, improved sound stage. Secondly, comfort for the long sessions that you guys are doing. Thirdly, durability and serviceability, because, well, you guys know that studio environment can be quite harsh to audio gear. And finally, the price to performance ratio, which is something that we all need. So let's start with sound. I have a box of different prototypes over here that we can explore and see. What is a good sound? Well, it comes down to two main categories. One is the objectively good sound, so something that you can measure and that we would universally, at least a little bit, agree on what it is. And secondly, of course, your subjective opinion, your taste, and whatever you like. So maybe more bass, maybe a little bit more high end, whatever. So based on the feedback from you guys, the X1 have to deliver on the flat frequency response similar or basically the same way that the S4 and S5X did. Now they are different. The S4 were made primarily for mixing stereo files basically, and the S5X were specifically tuned to mix immersive audio. So here's the twist: how do you put something like that together into one headphone? And the answer is actually quite simple. So the immersive audio requires to have a little bit more high-end presence in the frequency response, because the HRTFs, you know, how we actually hear certain frequencies and how we localize sound in the 360 panning around us, is very much supported or provided by HRTFs that live in the high spectrum, so above 4 or 5 kilohertz. So having headphones to play back a little bit more on the high spectrum helps with placing objects in the virtual 3D audio space. I know, you're gonna ask, but what about the stereo then? If you need a little bit less high end, how do you tweak these headphones? Well, they come with a calibration. So every unit is individually calibrated, and there is a software made by real phones and slightly adjusted for our needs that comes with every single unit. So you can run it as a plugin or as a standalone. So you can really just choose the target that you want. So when you're mixing something in a downmixed version, in a binaural downmix for Dolby, you would use the spatial target. And if you're just working in stereo, you would use the flat target, you know, provided by us. Or if you're a fan of the Harman target, so slightly more bass and a tilted room, well, then you just go with the Harman option that is also there in the software. The sound of the X1 is two-folded, so we have the calibration and the software on one side, and we have the acoustical engineering on the other side. So over here I have a cup. We have a speaker unit slightly eccentric to one side and also at an angle. The second really important part of the sound design for the X1 are the ear pads. So we have a very specific foam in here and the velour side, which both act as a flow resistor. They are basically creating a very specific acoustic impedance that will shape the frequency response specifically on the frequency bands below 1 kHz. That area is very much relying on the flow resistance, on the shape. So when it's all put together, we get the frequency response of the X1, which is kind of the mix between the S5 and the S4. So it works really, really well without the software. We can just plug them in and have incredibly nicely tuned pair of headphones. And then for the final mile, for the final 1 or 2 dB of correction, you turn on the calibration. And furthermore, of course, you can use room emulation and, you know, different target curves. How do you calibrate a headphone? Well, I'm glad you asked. I'm gonna invite you to our little secret lab over here. So the calibration for the headphone actually starts with the target curve. And the target curve is something that we've been developing for the past 5 or 6 years, something like that. So we went to a really good studio, the Synchron Stage in Vienna, and we captured a Dolby certified room, which was really recently certified. So it was like perfect, 1 dB perfect. So we captured that with the ear simulator, the full head and torso, to derive to a target curve that would work for binaural, for basically for immersive mixing. And then we did A-B testing with human subjects to wait it out and made it like work in a headphone scenario. So over here we have the ear simulator. That's not the one that is used for target curves, but it is used for calibrating headphones. To not get too technical, we are using the DRP device to basically calibrate every single headphone. So it's a part of the quality control process where we check that the headphone sounds as we want it to, and then we run some software to compare the pink noise on one side and then the pink noise that comes from the DOT, and we're comparing them together until they match. And there's like a little AI tool that does like a gazillion measurements and comparisons, you know, in a split second, to then derive to a calibration format, calibration file for that individual unit. So I'm inviting you to check, objectively check the measurements of these headphones in comparison to many other headphones. They are all published in a measurement report that we update about once a year with new models. So you can actually see, objectively see how they stack against Odyssey, Sennheiser, Biodynamics, and, you know, other brands in the world. So you can maybe make a little bit better, more educated decision if they are for you or maybe not. In this reverse unboxing video, the quality control is basically the last step before they get ready for packing and shipping to you guys for the unboxing experience. All right, so we talked about the sound, the calibration, the quality of sound, how we calibrate. Now let's talk a little bit about the comfort, because you guys are mixing for hours straight on. And those long sessions require a level of comfort. And that is something that is very, very, very important for us. The comfort is built or made out of multiple things in a headphone. So for one, the headband. So let's talk about it. So this one is made out of stainless steel. It's a spring steel, stainless spring steel. So you can extend it quite a lot and nothing will break. And the strap over here is something that the X1 inherited from the original S4X series. So it's elastic. You can just grab them, put them on your hat, and they will fit because of this self-adjusting strap over there. So the headband was designed to be really, friendly to anyone, giving a headphone to maybe someone else in the studio without needing to adjust things and without all the noise that headphones usually make. So that's part one, how they fit on your head. To touch on the ear cups a little bit, they rotate as mentioned, and they are also 95 millimeter in size. The ear pads themselves are a big component of the comfort. Oh, over here we have a mesh filter that just flew out. So the ear pads are 95 on the outside, but the important data for you would be the inner diameter, which is 57-58 millimeter in diameter. So that enables your peanut to rest in here. So these are over the ear cups or ear pads. All right, so that's on the comfort side. So the headband and the ear pads are the most important part of the comfort, as well as their weight. So they are not the lightest in the group. So many of these headphones over here will be lighter, but they are not heavy as in terms of, the Neumanns or the Odysseys and so on. So there you go. That is basically what I can say about the comfort. So before we conclude this reverse unboxing with the actual boxing of the product of the X1, I want to talk a little bit about the price and performance ratio, because that's the question that pops out quite a lot, especially in podcasts that I do with other podcast hosts. So the question usually goes something like that. So how can you guys create a headphone at such a level with individual calibration, with software, with 5 years warranty, out of great materials like, actual wood and stainless steel and aluminum backplates? How can you create a headphone like that in Europe and have it on the market for 500 euros, for 100 bucks, basically? And it's an intriguing question. So it does spark, how can you do that? Is there like some kind of a con or trick or scam behind it? Well, as you've seen, I've shown you the factory over here. So we are a very, very small team. All the audio is super small. It's just 5 full-time employees and 2 outsourced employees. So it's essentially a team of 7 people working on this project, on these headphones. That's also the reason why we only have 1 or 2 models available. So we don't build a product line of 10, 15, 20 different models, because that's just capital too intensive. And we cannot, with 5 people, it's impossible to sustain the quality required to serve you guys. So we drilled down, we niched down to professional audio. And even within that, only to mixing and recording. So right now the X1 is the mixing headphone. Of course, we are working on the closed back version, which will be for recording. So that's how we can trim down the costs and the overflow of, the overhead costs. We can keep them at bay by staying true to one lane, to one product, to one specific niche. And we deliver on that promise. That's just how we work. So all the efforts, all the research, all the support staff, everything that comes into creating a product, including sourcing. Our suppliers are vetted. We know exactly who they are, how they work. We know their tolerances that come from their materials and their processing, manufacturing processes. So we can kind of steer the ship or the development process and the product around what is available for a specific niche, and that gives us the edge. So we can actually produce incredibly high quality sound, incredibly high quality headphone in terms of durability, serviceability, which I didn't mention before. So you can actually buy spare parts for any of the parts of the headphones. You can buy from us and you can install it yourself without using any fancy tools or without any fancy skills. So it's just home tools, You can disassemble them and put them back together. You can play around if you want to as well. So that is a big plus, a big important part, but also reveals how we can actually deliver this kind of headphones at this level of consistency with calibration specifically, and still keep it at a reasonable price. That is the secret. There you go.